The case against Caylee is like a giant puzzle of circumstantial evidence with one giant piece missing.
And West 2's Bob Killing tells us without proof that Caylee was murdered, it could be much tougher for prosecutors to get the conviction they're looking for.
So how did Caylee Anthony die? Was it suffocation, strangulation, maybe accidental drowning? No one knows for sure.
This prosecution still has no evidence to show you exactly how she died. What caused her death? Was it accidental or was it intentional?
Some people who are following the case still don't believe that Caylee was murdered.
I believe it. It was an accident.
Without clearer evidence of how Caylee died, some say it would be hard for them to convict Caylee of premeditated murder.
It would be very tough, very tough, because there's always that in the back of your mind. It's a possibility that she might, you know, if she would just come out and say something.
Their goal is to get the death penalty. They need to come up with that evidence. You know, I don't think that it's way too weak.
Well, let's take a look at some of the considerable circumstantial evidence that prosecutors here at the state attorney's office do have. There were the web searches on the Anthony's home computer for neck breaking and how to make chloroform, suggesting premeditation. And then, of course, the duct tape on the child's skull still attached to the hair, suggesting possibly it was there even before the child died. Then there's the so-called smell of death inside Caylee's car, plus that single strand of decomposing human hair that investigators say was consistent with Caylee's.
It suggests a certain level of commitment or of premeditation.
At one time, Tom Luca represented Lee Anthony. He's also prosecuted around 50 homicide cases. He says the state can use Caylee's own lies and deception to fill the hole in their evidence.
If it's an accidental death, the prosecution is going to hammer the jury on why did she not come clean initially.
That argument rings true for others who followed the case against Caylee.
Whether it was an accident or not that killed her, the fact that she tried to cover it up still makes her guilty.
But this hole in the case leaves room for interpretation and doubt. Without Caylee's cause of death, jurors could find it significantly more difficult to convict Caylee of murder. In Orange County, I'm Bob Keeling, West 2 News.
We want to know what you think. Log on to our website and take the survey. Do you think Caylee's death was an accident? Weigh in for yourself. Go to West.com.